G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well in this crazy, crazy world that we've got going on at the moment. What I like to do now is probably outline the straps on the outside of them and the belt as well, just to sort of define them a little bit more. And later on, once we do all this sort of stuff, we can always go back to the uniform if we want to and add some extra highlights and lowlights and stuff like that. But I'm just trying to keep it simple. If you've seen my other videos, just for someone starting out. So I don't want to go too fast, and I find if I try and jam everything in, I'll miss something out or I'll go too quick and it won't be useful for people. So I'm just taking it slow. Hopefully you'll come out, you know, with your first or second or third figure as maybe an okay result. What I'd probably suggest is, if you want, is if you've got a four pack of figures like I've got and that I've showed in my first video, maybe start one and do video one and then video two, and then maybe once you've done that, stop and do your other figure on video one, and then video two, and then your third figure, maybe wait till you get to, and so on. So you can just see with each figure, if you you know, your mistakes, you'll know why you're doing them or how you can improve. And then with your next figure, and hopefully once you get to the figure four, you'll have this sort of little video tutorial down pat. If you can get Vallejo, grab Vallejo. I just like giving a little bit of information as well. A lot of sort of the nice figure painters and ones that I watch anyway, are starting to use this Joe Sonia as well. These paints, they're quite thin, and the one I like about the matte black here, or the carbon black, it dries very, very matte, very matte indeed. And the other thing I like about it, it's very cheap. It's about the same price as your Vallejo in your black, and I think you get about 17 mils in this, and I think you get about 75 mils in this. So huge, quite a saving, considering they're the same price. And I kind of think, apart from the thickness, they both do great jobs. So if you've got this in your art shop, it's about probably $5-6 Australian. You know, have a look at it and give it a go. Just always give your paints a good shake. And just because I was excited, guys, about doing this video, went out, got myself a new little brush, a Priston, I don't know, short liner, whatever that means, 10/0, and I just really like the look of it. It's a little bit of a thin wash, I suppose, and I kind of want that to run around my straps. So if you're not too sure and your hands are a bit shaky like mine are for some reason tonight, you can just run it over the strap, and then you can sort of bring your brush around down the side of it, so that way you're not just trying to get it on the part you want first. You can sort of test it out on the top of the strap and then bring it around. But we can do this. This will highlight the strap a little bit better. Now guys, if I go off camera for a minute, it's only because I'm trying to focus. So I'll try and hopefully edit those parts out and come back on board. Again, while you're doing this, if you find any other little detail that you want to bring out around, you know, the MO pouches, or maybe a little bit under the pockets, where the creases, where we've done our low lights before, while you've got this black, you can always touch up a little bit of the other things. Maybe under the collar, you can bring that out a little bit more. It's probably more of just a darker low light, if you like. And what we're doing here, guys, because we've got a bit of a finer brush, is very fine work. I was a bit slap happy at the start when we first did our first low light in the black right at the start. Was it the first video? I think it might have been the first videos. So this one's much more finer detailed work that we're trying to get across. When you're just starting out, don't get bogged down in every little nitty gritty. Sometimes if you get on certain websites and stuff, you'll get so bogged down with information that that's what will stop you from painting a figure. Or with armor guys, I think a lot of armor guys stop painting stop building kits because they're worried that it's not going to be as accurate as you know, someone's going to say it should be, or it's inaccurate. So, you know, it just puts them off the hobby. So as I said, you just paint it the way you want to paint it. But as long as you're improving with every figure and you're enjoying it, that's the main part, you're enjoying it, well then, who cares? Because I'm going off camera a bit, I'm just trying to show you by doing one side or the other. So pretty much all I've done is with my black, I've just outlined everything. So you can sort of see on the left side, I hope it is over here, left side, you can see how I've outlined all the pockets again. And I've sort of gone down around, I've even done sort of like the black down through between his legs there, where the seam would sort of be a bit. You don't have to do this, guys, but sometimes I get, you know, I'm just getting a little bit carried away while I'm doing it. I've got a very fine paintbrush, and this is very thin, this paint. And I've just, you can probably see, just run some very, very thin diluted lines down the trousers again, just to make some creases. The other thing is just think, this is probably going to be pretty much your heaviest low light or your darkest low light, if you think. So I'm just running that down underneath the main bits of the tunic where it's dark underneath. And this is really just where, I guess you're really just trying to make the uniform pop a bit. By putting the dark black around everywhere, and again all around the collar, I've done it down here. The collar might end up being black. It's got a black or dark grey on the box art, so I might change that. But I'm just doing this sort of black around here. Hopefully, it'll show up on camera. Possibly the difference between this side and that side. You can sort of see the pocket's not really defined over this side, but I've defined it over there. The other thing, just be careful, is sometimes like this one, the pocket comes over the outside of the strap, but it might not be sculpted very cleanly. So just be mindful of that. But over this side, you can't really see it, but over this side, you can sort of see the pocket coming out a bit more. And I'm just going around the buttons as well, to start bringing those out. They look like they're silver on the box art, but I'm not sure if they're actually a lighter field grey colour. I'll have to have a look at that. And just again, some little creases under here. Again, underneath the collar at the back, and also the top of the collar. And as you can see, I think I only did one of the boots. I might have done both, and I think I've done one. Hopefully, I've just gone around one boot there between the actual boot lip, if you like, or the top and the trouser where that meets, because that's going to be one of your pretty much your darkest area there. And then you're going to sort of go some lighter over the top. What you're really wanting to do is, again, like we did with the uniform, go your dark, then a bit of light, and a bit of lighter, and possibly, you know, which I haven't done here, drop some dark in where your buttonholes are, not your actual buttons, but your buttonholes, drop it in there as well. And really, again, like we did with the first lot of lowlights, we've got all the other layers on now, and we're just trying to make this, bring it out again to say, hey, this is where all the detail is again, just but more finer. And if you're really worried about making mistakes, just do a really quite a light, dilute your paint quite a bit so it's light. So when you go over it, if you make a mistake, it's not a biggie. But if you hit it on the right mark, you can just go back again, thicken your paint up. And once you get a bit more confidence going around your second or third time, you can just keep thickening your paint up. That's what I do. I just thin it out, go around once, go, yeah, I think I've done a good job there. Tip it back in your paint again, keep going around your figure, and then come back to that area again, and then just do another passing on it, rather than just filling your brush with thick paint, which you definitely don't want, and just blubbing it on. That's not what you want. You want thin paint also, because the beauty of that is if it's thin, you go down. If you make an accident, make a mistake, you can go and get another brush, just dip it, make it a little bit damp, and you can wipe it over where you've made the mistake, and it should come off reasonably easily. You don't want that the next brush that you is a bit damp, fully damp, because it'll just run everywhere. You just want it a little bit wet, just a tiny bit wet, so you can just wipe it off. That's all you're doing. As you can see, I've put a couple more black creases, and just some in one of my first videos, I said if you just think there's a crease there, there would be in real life. You can just run your black down there. Maybe try your wash in an area where you don't mind, like maybe under the tunic first here, and see if you're happy with how thin it is, and then just go over your figure. The other thing I forgot to say in one of my videos is when you're starting, probably a good idea is to get a piece of paper and write down the colours that you're using, because later on, life goes fast, you might like the colours you've used, and then when you want to try and remember them, you know, you can't remember. So what I like to do is get a piece of paper, and I might write down, you know, my low lights, and I might start at the, you know, the lowest, and then the middle, and then the high. And I might do my highlights, and I write that down too. And I write down all on a piece of paper. I normally write down the name of the figure that I've done it on, because sometimes you'll see have the paint work, but you don't know what figure. And that's always, and do it in like a spiral little notepad or something. And you can do that with all your figures. That way, when you think about, you know, your figures and what color you use, or you like that type of color that you used on your boots or your gloves, you can go back to it and have a look at it. And especially when you're just starting out, I really recommend that. And the other one is always remember to wash your brushes out at the end of the session and give them a good clean with whatever, in this case, just water. Even if you do make a mistake with the black, you've got your three colours, your green and your black and your whatever white you've used. So if you look back later and go, oh, I've put too much black on that, you know what colours you've used. So you can just go back with your green and just do a little tiny sort of wash as we did in the videos over the top, and it'll disappear. You can stop here, guys. If you're just a beginner and you think, you know what, this figure I am happy with. I don't need to do anything else to it. I'm more than happy, obviously, with his arms and his helmet and everything like that. But I'm talking about the uniform. You think, I'm more than happy with this figure. Well, then just stop, guys. You don't need to go any further. Just stop here. Obviously, you know, painting the buckles and everything, you know, excuse me, painting the buckles and the buttons and stuff. But I'm talking mainly about the uniform. If you think, look, I'm really happy with this, where we're at, you know, that's it. If you've got another 10 to do for a diorama, or you want to put them around a tank or in a group just having a coffee break, stop here and go and do your next 10 figures. We'll probably plodder along on this figure just to do some other things. But, you know, there's by no means that you have to keep following along. Well, follow along, of course, you know. But you don't have to keep going with your figure, you know. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you later.